Morning all of you. So we already started the next chapter, algebraic expressions, and how we can generalize that any algebraic expression. That also we discussed last class. Today we can discuss what is the terms and factors of an algebraic expression. Suppose one expression 3x square minus 5xy plus 11. Okay. This is an algebraic expression. Now, when we observe this algebraic expression, you look here, in this expression have three terms. One term is, first term is 3x square, and another second term is minus 5xy, and the third term is 11. So, terms are combined to form an algebraic expression with the addition or subtraction signs. Okay, so which is separated by addition or subtraction, then these are called the terms. First term is 3x square, and after that 3x square is one, subtraction is there. Next, second term is 5xy, then what is the sign of that 5xy? It is minus 5xy. So the second term is minus 5xy, and the third term is 11. Third term is a constant part, that is also a term. So now in the first expression, another example, you look, if the another expression, if it is 2y square plus 5xy plus 3y plus 8. Okay, this is also another algebraic expression. So how many terms are here? You look, how many? 1, then 2, 3, 4. Each terms are separated by with addition sign. So here four terms are there. Okay, these are called the terms of an algebraic expression. How it is expressed, it is combined as the combined with the addition or subtraction, then that are called the terms of that expression. So this way we can find out in each expression how many terms will be there. So that is clear what is mean by terms of an algebraic expression. Now, what is, now you look here, in this expression 3x square minus 5xy plus 3x square plus 11. 3x square minus 5xy plus 11. In this term, the first expression, first term 3x square, it is a product of which terms, which factors you look? 3. One factor is 3 and another factor is x, this x. Now this is the product of 3x square, is the product of 3 into x into x. Okay, 3x square we can write as the product of 3 into x. So we can call 3x. These are the factors of the first term. Factors that we know, factors already we know. What are the factors of a number? 4. What are the factors of 4? 1, 2 and 4, that all of you know. So here 3x square, already we know in the first term 3x square, the constant term, constant part is 3 and the variable part is x square. And this term is formed by the product of 3 into x. So these are called the factors of the first term. Okay. Now when we consider the second term, how this second term is formed by, as the product of which factors? Here numerical part is minus 5. Constant part we can call it as numerical part. Numerical part it is minus 5 and another x and y. So the second term is formed as the product of the factors minus 5 into x into y. So these are the factors of the second term. And the third term is the constant term, that is 11, 1 into 11. We can 11 write as 11 as the product of 1 into 11. So which are the factors? Only 11 or 1 into 11. So term and the factors, all of you clear. Another expression, if it is 3, otherwise 13 y cube minus 5 y square plus 6. Okay, in this term, in this expression, how many terms are there? All of you know, how many terms? 1, 2, 3. 3 terms are there. And in each term, what are the factors? First term, What are the factors? So here 13 is a factor, and here this y cube. So we can write as the product of y into y. Okay, 13 into y into y into y will be 13y cube. So the factors of this first term is 13y, y and y. 13 into y into y into y. Just like here the second term is minus 5s, y square. So its factors are minus 5. One factor is minus 5. Then 1y, another one more y. So minus 5 into y. That will be the product of this. We'll get a minus 5y square. So the factors of the second term is minus 5, y and y. Just like what are the factors of 6? That we know 6 we can write it as, if it is a common we can write it, the factor is only 1 into 6 is 6, otherwise 2 into 3, that way also we can write it, 2 into 3 also 6, or simply we can write it as 6. In the case of algebraic expression, when we consider the factors of 6, we can simply, because it is a constant part, we can simply write the factor of these are 6 itself, otherwise 2 into 3, anyway it is possible. So all of you clear about factors and terms of an algebraic expression. Okay, clear. Now when we consider another expressions like this, look, different algebraic expression I am writing here. 7 p cube, one expression. This is also one expression. Another one, 8 p square q square plus 3. Then another one, 15 n cube m square n plus 6 m n plus 7. Okay, now in this expression, when we consider this expression, you look, in the first algebraic expression there is only one term. Okay, it is not separated by any other addition sign and subtraction sign. Okay, so in the first expression it contains only one term. So such expressions are called monomial. Okay, what is called? An algebraic expression containing only one term is called a monomial. Now in the second expression, look, it is 8p square q square plus 3. 8p square q square plus 3. How many terms here? Two terms. So if an algebraic expression contains only two terms, we can call it as binomial. Okay, binomial, two terms, then it's called binomial. So what will be an algebraic expression with the three terms? We can call it as trinomial. Okay, trinomial, clear. So an algebraic expression containing only one term is monomial. If it is two, it is called binomial, and if it is three terms, it is called a trinomial. And also generally all these algebraic expressions containing more than three, generally we can call them polynomial. Okay, polynomial. Okay, generally. So 7p cube also a polynomial. 8p square q square plus 3 also another polynomial. 15m square n plus 6mn plus 7, that's also another polynomial. But separately or specially we can call, if a polynomial contains only one term, it is monomial. If it is only two terms, it is binomial. If it is three terms, it is called a trinomial. Generally, all the algebraic expressions with one condition, for an algebraic expression and polynomials have some difference. That you want to care. You look, this one example I am writing. 3 divided by x square plus 5x minus 7. This is an algebraic expression. Okay, 3 by x square. Here contains 3 terms and here contains variables and constants. So we can call it as, it is an algebraic expression. Which is the first term? 3 by x square. Second term is 5x and third term is the constant part minus 7. Now, but here what will be the power of this x? The power of this x will be, this is in the denominator part. So when we write its power, it will be actually its power. We can write 3 into, that we learned using exponents law, we can write it as 3x raised to x square we can write as 3x raised to minus 2. Instead of this 3 by x square we can rearrange this as 3x raised to minus 2 plus 5x minus 7. Now here you look, what is the power of this x now? It is minus. Okay, otherwise here when we write this in this form, it will be in the variable, will be in the denominator part. Such algebraic expression will not be including polynomials. It is not a polynomial. It is an algebraic expression, but it is not a polynomial. So what is the condition to become a polynomial? An algebraic expression, we can call it as a polynomial if its variable have only positive exponents, positive powers, then only we can call them as polynomials. Here you look, all these powers are positive, so that will be included in the set of polynomial. But in this case, you look, when we arrange this in this way, it is denominator part. That's why also it is not a polynomial. If any variable came in the denominator part, it will not be included polynomial. Otherwise, if you rearrange this as using exponents law, its power will be negative. So this is also not a polynomial. So all algebraic expressions are not polynomial, but all polynomials are algebraic expression. Okay, so for polynomials, there will be one condition: its powers of the variable should be positive. Such algebraic expressions only called polynomial. Okay, thank you.